Good morning, everybody. Good morning! Blah, 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 blah. I feel a lot better today. I feel a lot better. I'm so glad that I slept yesterday. I'm so glad. I felt so bad because I was gonna do a collab and, well, I do sound a lot better. Oh my god. If you guys were there during the Squid Game collab thing, that shit was whack. I sounded like I didn't sound good. I didn't sound good. I sound good right now, though. I sound good. I have a bit of congestion, but it's not so bad. And what else? Oh yeah, I got a tissue up my nose because I think I was blowing my nose so much that I gave myself a bloody nose. What the fuck?
Eat Long John Silver's tipped 4.2 million. They put you in Fortnite. Check it out on NFL.com.
Oh, they put me in Fortnite? Fucking finally. Jesus Christ. I've only been Fortnite's biggest fan for the past month. It's about fucking time they realized what a great asset I am to them. No, it hasn't even been a month, it's been 3 weeks. I've been Fortnite's biggest fan for 3 weeks. Thank you guys all so much for the resubscriptions. Thank you, Clavu and True Sir Sleepy and Protostash and Sora and Blazing Knights and Nasal. Literally me. And the Red Hunter for the resubscriptions, and Cogstopper, and King Orsic, and Paint Chip, and Niles, and did I miss any of you guys? And Frizz Frazzled, and Mia, and Squarings, and Captain Green Beans. And Nightbot. Thank you guys all so much. Thank you for being here. I started streaming at 11:14 p.m. And thank you, the Burninator, for the resubscription with Prime. And Huggy Wuggy. And Kissy Missy. And Squid Game Huggy Wuggy. And Ren the Rock. Thank you, Ren the Rock, for the resubscription. Fulfalina. Zumbo Sauce. Yeah. Squid Game. I had a good day today. I'm feeling better. And give me a freaking username. And Freddy Fazbear. Yeah, it's been a good day. And Fucky Wucky. And Huggy Wuggy. Stop farting. That ain't me, bro. That ain't me. That's you. I'm not farting. I would never fart. I don't fart. I shit. No way. And Boogie 2988. Yeah, girls don't fart. Girls don't fart. They shit. Maybe if you were wearing the jacket they stole from you, you wouldn't be sick. I have a jacket. In fact, I have an even better jacket now than the one I got stolen from me. Fuck those guys, by the way. Steal my money. But as soon as you steal my fucking coat, that's where I draw the line. Like, how awful of a person do you have to be to not only steal somebody's money but steal their freaking coat in the rain? Come on! Hello, Mario. Hello, homosexual viewer. Urania. Thank you. Thank you for the resubscription. You didn't, the bitch that stole it? No, I didn't. I didn't, the bitch that stole it, unfortunately. You know, they were supposed to, like, give me the, what do you call it? The camera thing. Here, let me get on, hold on, let me... They're supposed to give me, like, the camera thing, whatever you call it. When you go to the camera, and you say, hey, I filed a police report. Give me it, and they say, okay. But they didn't. They didn't give me it. They did have a video. They did. And I said, can I have it? And they said, yeah, we'll call you. And I said, okay. Never called me. Never called me. And they never called anyone, know what? And the police never cared. So it doesn't matter if I have the footage. It doesn't matter if I have the footage. Because you wanna know what? Police don't give a shit. You tell them, I got my money stolen. If you file a police report, they laugh in your face. Or they may as well be laughing in your face. They know that they're not gonna. Mm-mm. They don't care. Mm-mm. They don't care. I don't live in California. Why does everybody think I live in California? Well. If it isn't Mari underscore Yen. I don't live in California. I don't. West Coast energy. West Coast represent. Now put your hands up. Oh. Yeah, there are a lot of people who live in California. Californication. I had to learn on stream that fornicating meant doing the dirty. I thought it meant I thought it meant shitting. I thought fornicating meant shitting. I don't know why. It's like, I don't know. I think I was playing like Cool Spot or something, and I started singing Californication. And I had to learn from chat that fornicating was not shitting. California shitting. Well, that would make sense too though, right? Yeah. POV live in San Francisco. The Red Hot Chili Peppers. No, I don't. Maybe I give West Coast vibes. Okay. Maybe I give West Coast vibes. And maybe I am on the West Coast. But I wasn't always this way. I grew up in Montana. I grew up in Montana. That is not West Coast. That is like North. People say Midwest. Montana is in the Midwest. The Midwest doesn't claim Montana. Montana is the meth capital of the United States, and I mean that. The only thing that I've known growing up is they always told me Montana is known for three things. Number one, we have the most cows per capita. Number two, we have the most suicides per capita. And number three, we have a really bad meth problem. And that's what I learned growing up. Yeah. And no, to be frank with you, there's only three things also that you can do growing up in Montana. Number one, go on a fucking hike. Number two, go bowling. Or number three, do drugs. That's it. Those are the only things you can do. I believe it. The only people who go to Montana are like... for some reason, like, the only time anyone ever moves there is if they want to go into forestry. Every time I've been back home, and like, when you get in an Uber or a taxi in like a smaller area, you always have to talk to the person driving you. And so usually I'll ask about like, oh, who are you? Where are you from? What are you doing? And I think like 8 times out of 10, they will bring up forestry. Like, I don't know. The only thing to do in the mountains is fornicate. If you're talking shitting, then yes, but if you're talking having sex, then maybe not. My mom used to say, is Christmas over? Not in my heart. It's not. Maybe to everybody else it is. But... no. Shitting is fornication. No, fornication is having sex, but I thought it was shitting. Yeah. No, I can guess that's what I'm saying, though. My mom used to always tell me, she's like, do you want to know why so many people have birthdays in July? And I said, why, Mom? And she said, because people are trying to fuck in the winter to keep warm. And that's why I was born in July. I was born out of circumstance. And I have been very aware of that ever since my conception. Yeah. My circumcision. Ever since my circumcision, I didn't get one of those. Am I a Cancer or a Leo? Why don't you take a wild guess? I'm as cancerous as they come, baby. Is that even a fucking question? I am so cancerous. I'm just a snippy little thing. I got my claws out. Snip, 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 snip. I am so snippy. Not depressed enough. Not depressed enough for what? For being a cancer? What, where did you get that information from? Fucking Homestuck? Who says cancers are depressed? No way. They read their daily horoscope. Dude, I don't like... So the reason I never became a Zodiac bitch... I probably should've because I loved Sailor Moon so much. And I was like, oh my god. Sailor Moon and I are both Cancer, which means that we're the same for real, for real. And it's honestly crazy that I didn't become a Zodiac person. But you want to know why? It's because all of the Zodiacs, all of the horoscopes for Cancer fucking suck. Every time you read a Cancer Zodiac, it's like, wow, Cancer, fuck you, you closed off son of a bitch. Yeah, crying is really gonna get you somewhere. Stupid, dumb crab. Why don't you just go die? That's literally every Cancer Zodiac. Every Cancer horoscope is the same. And it's like, oh god, I can't do it. So that's why I never became a zodiac person. I feel like if you're a zodiac person, you're probably like, What's a zodiac sign that never gets shit? Aries? Aries, probably. Gemini. No, Gemini gets shit all the time. Gemini always gets shit. Virgo. Yeah, maybe Virgo. Or Zodiac just a white woman thing? No, there's Chinese Zodiac too. So no, not really. It's kind of like an everywhere thing. People are fascinated with the stars. Also, someone earlier asked if Homestuck cosplayers still exist. I regret to inform you that they do, but it's pretty few and far between, so I guess nature is healing. You know, I went to a con, and I have to tell you something. Soul Eater is fucking coming back with a vengeance. Like, what is happening? What is happening? It's nature is healing. I ran into this guy who was cosplaying Death the Kid, and I stopped and I was like, wow, I can't believe this. And I told them, I was like, I love your costume. I love that. And they're like, yeah, thank you. It's actually my, like, 10-year anniversary of cosplaying. And they were redoing the cosplay that they first did, which was Death the Kid. And I thought that was awesome. And I was talking to them about how there were so many more Soul Eater cosplayers this year than I usually see. And this other guy comes along and he's like, hey, I like your costume. And then we all start talking. And then I jokingly say, hey, next year, let's meet in the same place all cosplaying Soul Eater characters. And they go, that's a great idea. And the other guy says, actually, I was thinking of doing Medusa this year, but I got cold feet. And then the Death the Kid cosplayer says, yeah, do you want to exchange Instagram? And I was like, oh, fuck. I didn't think we would get this far. They're like, do you have a Twitter or do you have an Instagram? And immediately when they said Twitter, like, my eye, like, my... I said Twitter, my life flashed before my eyes, and I was like, they don't know I'm a YouTuber. They don't know I shouldn't be here right now. So I gave these random ass people. I gave these random ass people the Instagram I used to talk to my mom. And I never talked to them again. They don't know who I am. We never talked after that. But one of the guys, I don't think we ever even followed each other. Yeah, so... yeah. Isn't that crazy? Also, Folded Metal, how is your stream? What were you? I know you were doing something with like spam or whatever. Yeah, I should be Death the Kid at my next con. Yeah, sure. So you guys can all hunt me down and kill me. Yeah. Sure. No, I'm the killer. No, I wouldn't be Death though. I would be Death the Kid. Death is my father. That's what he says. It was anniversary spam Masubi stream. So I did the second spam Masubi stream and the flavored ones are really bad. Wait, what flavors of spam are there? There's hot, there's red, there's green, there's teriyaki, there's bacon, I don't know. I've only had one kind of spam. Regular. Maple flavored. Oh wow, this is a lot of spam. Real bacon spam, maple spam, turkey spam, hickory smoke, Tocino's seasoning, spam single? What the fuck? Spam singles? Like just one? There's a pumpkin spice spam, but it's very rare. There's no way. No way. Actually, can I be for real? I think pumpkin spice spam might actually go kind of crazy. It will. Spam teriyaki. Okay, to be fair though, you are the spam expert. I've only ever tried regular spam. So I don't know. Truly, I don't. Spam classic. What's the difference between spam classic and spam classic? Why do they have two different contain- Oh, 7 ounce. There's a 7 ounce thing of spam or a 12 ounce thing of spam. Yeah, put spam in fried rice. Kimchi fried rice. Put spam in anything. Do you dice it? I mean, yeah, if you put it in fried rice. Yeah. Is there impossible spam? I mean, personally, I think that all spam is possible. It's just, you know, we don't know what we're getting. We just have to try it. Like, the sky is the limit. This guy tried 12 different spams. Oh, plant-based spam. That's what you're telling me. Wait, trying every spam I could get my hands on. This is a fucking 41-minute video about a guy trying 12 different spams. Let me... Here, I'm actually a little bit curious. You said plant-based. Is this about worms? We can make it about worms. If you guys were worms... I would still care about you, I guess. I'm trying to get this shit on the screen. New England Wildlife and More.
Hey everyone, today I have a whole bunch of spam flavors that I'm going to be trying out to see what I like best.
Oh my god! He does have the pumpkin spice one!
I've the original, which I don't really like. I don't like the texture.
Have you ever eaten Mexican food?
Cut it really thin.
No, I've only eaten Mexican food.
Still, I don't really like it. But I actually really like bacon flavored spam. You cut it thin, crisp up in a frying pan. To me, it tastes just like bacon if you make it like that.
I like plantain.
But these are all the
flavors. Yes, spam figgy pudding.
Yes, they do make a couple other ones, but they're hard to get because they're not made
in this country. I'm gonna be real with you guys.
And also, the store does not sell this
variety. Today.
I went to a couple different Walmarts.
It kind of hit.
Get, I think three of them from the
it kind
of
hit a little bit.
The rest of them
usually I'm a Chipotle denier,
cheap.
But
they're about the same
in
price,
an hour
not
of need, it comes in clutch.
And then there was a couple that cost a bit more.
I'm still kind of a Chipotle denier, though.
$10, not too bad.
Yeah, a bowl.
But
I got
also
a bowl.
Got this one here, which is pumpkin spice.
But you want to know fucking what is awful about Chipotle? They skimp on you. Dude. They skimp on you. If you're not there to be, like, on their ass, they skimp hardcore on your fucking meats, alright?
Flavored. It's been discontinued since 2019. So, because it's discontinued...
More sauce, please!
You gotta find it from somebody who has a stockpile.
I don't think I got
so
any sauce.
Oh,
no, I got...
$90
salsa.
It better be good for that price. But I wanted to try to add it to this video since it was
I got steak.
We also got this one here, which is from Korea.
Salsa.
A weird cheesy flavor.
And black beans.
I know spam makes a normal size can of cheese.
And fajita vegetables.
But I was unable to get it because it's kind of rare.
Yeah, so here we got a bunch
of
flavors.
What did I get?
So, the low sodium one and the bacon one I was able to get at Walmart. The low sodium
rice?
Is basically the same as the original,
rice
so I didn't
it?
Even bother getting both of them. Now, what else was I able to actually get in the store? I think hickory smoked
honestly,
came from the
I
actual
think that was
store.
It.
And I think hot and spicy may have come from the actual store. I know these ones I had to buy on Amazon because the store didn't have them. This one here I got on
I
eBay,
have kinda shit taste.
Which is going to be a little weird. You can
no
cut
corn,
it up like
no
that
corn.
And stretch it open. I wonder how that'll be. So all of these come fully cooked. You are not required to cook it. You can just slice it up.
Either.
You can put it in a sandwich. Or you can take a
People
big bite
like
out of the
it,
chunk
but
like an
I,
apple. I want to try them all
I'm
raw.
I'm neutral on guacamole.
And maybe I'll try cooking up a slice of each
I'm
one
neutral.
To see how they are. These
Eat
when
the figgy
opened,
pudding
you can cover
spam!
Them up with just a piece of plastic or aluminum foil. You can keep them in the refrigerator.
Eat.
It says on there up to, I think it says a week. Is that what it says? No, it says 3 to 5 days. You can put them in the refrigerator. So I'll eat
dude,
as much as
dude,
I can,
dude,
and then the
dude,
rest of it
Chipotle,
will put out at
Chipotle
trail cameras to
fucking
see
sucks,
what
and
flavor
I'm gonna kick them in their butthole because Chipotle
this
had
an interesting
like
flavor.
This chicken.
I think it might be pretty
Alpastor.
Gross, but who knows? Maybe it'll surprise me. We'll
Did
give that
Alpastor.
A try. I also think this will probably be very good too. The maple,
no, they
especially
had
if I crisp it up like bacon, like this one
yeah,
I
no,
mentioned.
No, no,
if you
not
cut
chicken.
It thin,
They had
it fries
store.
Up, it tastes just like bacon once you get it crisp
and
up
it was
enough
good as
where it's
fuck.
A little crunchy.
Okay,
I'm
and they got
the
rid
same
of it
result
because
there,
it was limited
I absolutely
time.
Love maple flavored bacon.
Why would you make
this
a limited
one, I
time
that.
Meat?
I like smoked
Why
bacon,
would you do that?
Actually, not really. I'd much prefer
just
that.
Just keep it.
So, in my opinion, before I even get started, I'll probably really like this one. I'll probably like this one. I know I like that one. What about this one? I don't know.
Maybe they ran out.
We will
how the
find
fuck
out.
Do they
the
run
turkey
out
one
of...
might be gross, or maybe when
how
I cut it up,
run
it'll be just
out
like cold
of
cuts.
Meat.
I'm not sure. That's why I'm making this video.
You can just
I'm very
run
curious
out.
About the flavors of spam.
Just order more.
Today.
Yeah,
I'm also
cow's
very curious
closed.
About this one here. It's a limited edition, but they do
Open
still make it.
Open it and eat it!
Let me give you Ooh. All a close-up look at this can in case anyone's interested in reading it.
Please. Oh. Oh, wait. Okay. Consider the pumpkin spice spam on a waffle with syrup? Okay. Go crazy. I don't care what you guys say. I would try it. Don't be a naysayer. What are you scared of?
Fully cooked, ready to eat. You don't even have to cook it up if you don't want. But it shows right here in the picture, somebody obviously
once.
Cooked it up and threw it on some waffles with some syrup and whipped cream. Right, see, here we got the one from Korea. This actually shipped very fast. Can't believe it got here in 4 days.
What is it?
And I know it came from Korea because it said Korea Post on it. They
or
just
is it just
express
Korean
shipped
spam?
It over here.
Is that it? That's a
looks
cheese
like it's got
one.
An expiration date of 2025.
Cheese spam sounds like
and
the
worst.
And this
one here, it looks like it's got a resealable cover. Kind of cool, the resealable cover, because I can actually use this in the future. It actually says spam on it. That's kind of cool.
Well,
I bet I could probably get more.
Listen, I don't
of
care
these
if it's Korean,
covers,
okay?
Because
I don't
any of these, you can
the
save them for a bit
spam.
Of time. Figgy pudding, limited edition.
Figgy pudding.
Just in case anyone wants to get a look at any of these.
Wait,
I'll make
is
sure
it really figgy
everything
pudding,
focuses
or is it figgy
in.
Pudding flavored spam?
And then we're going to go upstairs into the kitchen and open all these things on up.
Because I've never had figgy pudding before.
Some people have an interest
it's
of
it's figgy
exactly
pudding
what the
flavored?
Say.
Ooh, okay.
Some people don't. So if you don't have any interest in this, you are welcome to skip forward in the video a couple of minutes. Some
the
of these have a bigger
spam.
Shelf life than I would have expected. 2026. Although, it's only about a 2.5
show
years from
but
now.
The ingredients. You don't
keep
need to see the ingredients.
How far we
it's
are
spam.
Along already.
If you see the ingredients, you're probably gonna go into shock. Just eat it. Just close your eyes and eat it.
A lot of these cans. I'm sure the raccoons are gonna have a lot of fun.
Honestly,
most people
I've
I
probably
know think
eaten
spam
worse
is absolutely
spam
disgusting
and
will
cared less.
Refuse to even touch it.
I don't know why people are so scared of spam for.
It
preservatives
depends,
are good for you.
I hate the
they
flavor.
They keep you strong.
I mean, I hate the texture. It's like a pate. Even my cat refuses to eat anything that's pate.
I'm going
to
fill my body full of preservatives and
microplastics.
To
me, it's a very gross texture. But if I fry it up and it's a little crispy, I have anything that's pate.
The spam taco?
To me, it's a very gross texture.
Go crazy. Go crazy.
Texture. But if I fry it up and it's a little crispy, I have no problem with it at all.
Yes. Yes. Oven roasted turkey spam. Does the turkey spam even taste like turkey? Or does it taste like spam? I want to try the turkey spam.
That one's got a long
I would try it.
Date.
Turkey spam
masubi?
The
past couple of weeks.
Well, I don't
except
know.
Except the bacon one. That's
bacon
been sitting
spam?
In my
I don't really like bacon.
Cabinet for quite a while.
Tocino seasoning. It's not Tostino, it's Tocino. How am I feeling?
Date.
I'm feeling a lot better.
Well, I gotta stop saying that. It is a Best Buy date.
I'm really glad that yesterday I went to bed.
Expiration date. That come in a can.
A cam? Spam cam. I'm glad. I felt really sad though because I had to end my Squid Game collab early yesterday. And
teriyaki.
I was getting ready for my collab with Barry and Imakuni, and I was sitting in the voice call preparing, and I was getting like so fucking hot. And I just like, I was like, hey, I need to lay down. I need to lay
one.
Down
Let's
for
see
a
the
moment.
Expiration date on this one's gonna
and
be.
When I laid down, like I realized that I was not going to be able to get back up.
For a little bit of time.
Am I feeling better? I'm feeling a lot better. I think after today, I'll probably be
yeah,
basically
not even that
better.
Bad.
Which is awesome because last year all I got right, sick everyone. Around the same time and I was sick for like over a week. So I was scared. Oh no. It's not COVID. It better not be COVID. I didn't test it. I don't know. What channel was the Squid Game on? It was on Meriwether's channel.
All right, everyone. We got a whole ton of spam set up on those
look
plates.
At all that spam.
Now we're going to get to opening them all up and looking at what they look like on the insides. All right, everyone. We made it up into the kitchen. And now it's time to
is
open
he gonna
it up.
Is he
going to
start with the pumpkin
like inside,
spice one?
And go ahead and eat it.
Did I win? No, I really
time to
didn't.
Open it on up.
The only thing I won in was being a big bitch. Because in one of the games,
suck on in.
You know that one where you like jump on the glass bridge?
Give it a big sniff.
And then everyone is supposed to follow you, and one of them cracks, and the other one doesn't.
If I sniff deep enough, I can definitely smell pumpkin.
I was the first one to jump, and
if you don't really sniff in there,
I stood there on the glass bridge, and every single time somebody tried to jump on with me, I would push them off. Eventually, I fell off, but I felt good to be a nuisance. There we
go. Whop.
Wow, that is awful. That's the pumpkin spice one.
Definitely going to keep the container. Look at that.
You would go first. Yeah, I would. I'm not scared of losing my life. Because I'm not a
jalapeno
bitch.
Spam. What's this going to smell like?
Jalapeno spam.
Wow.
Definitely spicy in there. Look at that.
I really hate jalapenos.
Smells very spicy.
They are really, really gross to me.
Yeah. Very, very spicy in there.
Oh, okay. I want to watch you eat them. Boom. I think they're great. A lot of people think jalapenos are great.
Wow.
This guy's got some autistic riz. He reminds me of me when I was younger and I wanted to be XD random.
Doesn't
so every single time I would
jalapeno,
like drop something, I would go
like
womp.
There.
A little bit orangey,
you know?
Around the edges.
Get it on out. These ones are coming out easier than the pumpkin. Probably because they just been in there a while. This one actually looks very orangey,
You're
too.
You're making me remember things about yourself you don't want to.
Smells
this
kind
is
of
an experience.
In my opinion. Look at that.
Coming to Marimar underscore Yen stream means that we have to have a breakthrough together.
Easy.
What's Tocino? It's a seasoning. I don't know what's in the seasoning. Bro.
Now we gotta open up the cheesy one.
Yeah, no.
Well, this one opened a bit differently. It's like overly packed.
Not the
in
cheese
there.
Spam.
Not a lot of space.
Not the cheese spam.
Push tab right into it.
Not the cheese spam.
It smells normal. I don't smell cheese at all. Maybe I see a little cheese around the edge, but I'm not smelling it.
Get it on out. All right.
I don't see the cheese
good.
Either.
Now the hickory smoke flavor.
I really want to watch you eat them, so
looks
I'm going to skip past all of this.
Pacino? Cheese?
Oh, there it is.
Hickory smoke?
There's the cheese.
Less sodium?
Ugh.
Maple? Turkey?
It reminds
teriyaki.
Me of one of those weird cheesy bratwurst.
We got the pumpkin. We got the bacon and the figgy pudding.
Ooh, the figgy pudding is
absolutely
breathtaking.
Time to get the knife out and cut a little piece off each one, see how they taste.
The figgy pudding and the pumpkin spice
spam
look fucking crazy.
And give them all a taste test.
Yeah, seriously, regular spam can't be beat. Well, low sodium is good.
Hot and spicy, how's this gonna be? Let's get off a piece.
I want to try the turkey one because I feel like that wouldn't be an insult to my senses.
Hmm.
Wait, which one is... Oh, that's hot and spicy.
I like it. It started off good, but now my mouth is on fire from it after having it in there a couple of seconds. Mouth is on fire.
Oh.
Maybe we can cool it down with some jalapeno. Or make it 100 times
jalapeno.
Worse. Wow, take a look at this. Once I cut into the
jalapeno,
it's really got some big
jalapeno.
Chunks of pepper in there.
I thought I was just mishearing him.
Good piece.
But he really is saying jalapeno. If I were
that is
a rich
actually
man.
Really good.
Yeah, da 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 da.
I like that a lot.
Say I would
spicy.
Have all the
and that's
spam
something
in the world.
So awesome
if
on
I was
crackers.
A wealthy man.
I like it so much better than the original spam. Can't believe I've never tried it before.
Gwen Stefani. Gwen Stefani.
Very unique flavor. To me, it tastes like honey chicken or something.
Wait, what?
Very good flavor. Now time to get a chunk of the cheese. Now this one here, I want to give you a close-up look, because look, there's actually also big chunks of cheese mixed in with it, which is kind of cool.
No.
Get a piece off that.
But also Fiddler on the Roof.
I can barely taste the cheese going into it. But once my mouth heats up the cheese, now I can taste it a little bit, but not
cheese
too much
spin different
than
sounds
normal.
Sounds great. Spam.
Now let's try the hickory smoke, which I think will maybe be similar to bacon.
I don't really like... This guy's got a crazy... Whoa, he's a new male.
To me, it tastes just like smoked ham.
He's a new male. He's got
less
that
sodium,
neck crook.
Which is going to be just exactly like the original.
He's got that, the gamer hunch. I didn't even know this because I was so focused on the spam.
Not that bad, actually.
Which one is that? Is that maple?
Maple. I think this is going to be fantastic.
Oh, he's eating the maple.
Look at it. It's so brown because it's covered in so much syrup. That tastes just like maple bacon without the crunchiness.
He likes it.
That'll be fantastic.
Folded metal, are you still here? He likes it.
Minutes.
He likes the maple
stovetop.
Bacon.
I'm gonna get a frying pan out. Now, we got turkey
flavor. The maple
flavor.
Spam. Turkey.
Get a good chunk off that. Here.
Come on.
I honestly can't taste the difference from the original spam and the turkey. Not much of a difference, except the turkey is a little darker in color.
Oh.
Now we got a piece of teriyaki spam.
Ooh, teriyaki spam? Okay.
That's awesome. Tastes just like teriyaki seasoned chicken.
Okay.
Now, the one we've all been
waiting
for.
Yes, 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 yes.
Limited edition pumpkin spice.
Yes.
Let's see. It's a lot better than I thought it would be.
Oh.
Definitely don't hate it. Bacon spam.
Wait, you're just moving on like that? That's
before.
It?
Not
Bro.
Bad at all, but I think...
Bro, I waited all this time.
All these.
And you're just...
Maybe the jalapeno would be great for eating cold on crackers. I like it for that.
This guy is not a good reviewer.
Spam. Gotta give this one a try.
Jalapeno.
Awesome. This would make a good dessert after eating all the other spams.
What?
Mm.
Dude, this guy just went through all of these and said that he likes them all. This guy just ate every flavor of spam, and resoundingly, he said he liked every single one of them. And he said that the figgy pudding spam was a good dessert. This is meat. This is meat, by the way. People that willingly eat spam are not picky. That is not true. I would willingly eat spam, and I feel like I'm slightly picky. I'm fairly picky. Because I don't like cheese. I don't like cheese, and everyone likes cheese. I am slightly picky. I don't like cheese. I like mozzarella sometimes. Yeah, of course I would eat anything if it was offered to me, but that doesn't mean I would like it. You know, if somebody offered me, like, cheese, I'd be like, okay, I would eat this, but I would never choose to eat it, you know? The picky eater test. Below for anything you would not eat. Well, the thing is, I would eat anything, right? I would eat it, but it's just like, what do I want to eat? If I have a choice, like... Why the fuck would I eat cheese if I don't like it that much? But if you're saying, like, picky, like, ew, I won't eat this. Oh, I do like cottage cheese, though. Cottage cheese is, like, one of my favorite foods, but I don't like... I don't really like cheddar or anything like that. Yeah, picky eaters will not eat the thing. Well, people still call me picky for it, though. Just because they say I don't like this food. But if I have to choose anything that I truly wouldn't eat, honestly... Well... Any of these things I... Okay, so here's my analysis. I would eat literally any of these things once. You know, at least once. If somebody offered me any of this and was like, hey, can you try a bite? I would at least try a bite of anything. Thank you, John, for the raid, by the way. But if I had to, like, choose everything that I don't like, let's see. I don't like Nutella. I don't really like oysters. I don't think I would like snails. I remember sourdough bread being, like, I didn't like it when I was a little kid. So I don't know about this, but... Vinegar? Well, why would anybody eat vinegar? You guys can't see it, but like... Why would anyone eat that? I feel like this is a bad thing to put on. Tomatoes, cucumbers, eggs, cabbage... I like all this stuff. I don't like liver. I like all this stuff, though. I like all this except liver. And then over here... I'm not a huge fan of avocado. And, I really don't like mushrooms. I really don't like mushrooms. I wouldn't choose to eat eggplant, but it's fine. Let's see. Yeah, and that's about it. Some of these things on this last list are literally my favorite things in the whole wide world. Apples, cottage cheese, beets, pickles, and olives are like five of my favorite foods in the whole wide world. I don't have terrible taste! I don't. I kind of do. I don't have terrible taste. I don't. Do you like chocolate? Of course I like chocolate. Of course I do. Black or green olives? I prefer black olives. But I like both of them. I don't have bad taste, I just have weird taste. Like, you can't hate on me for that. Would I try new foreign cuisine? Yeah, of course I would. I just said it. I said I would try anything at least once. But Everybody calls me picky. Everyone says, oh, you're so picky because you don't like cheese. And I'm not picky. I just wouldn't put it on my food. I don't like it. If somebody was like, hey, do you want to get a cheese pizza? I'd probably be like, no, thanks. You can get that. That's not picky! Being picky is not eating a bunch of different things. I would eat it if I had to. That's literally not picky. I went through all of these. I went through all of these and there was only like 5 things that I don't like. That's it. Like, what do you want? Like, I just don't like pizza that much. I don't know why that's such a travesty. Oh no, I don't like what you like. Man, that must suck for you. What would I not eat that's off the list? I don't really like cheese. I like blue, okay. There's a few exceptions. I like blue cheese and I like cottage cheese and I like mozzarella. But almost every other cheese I'm not really a fan of. I don't know, usually it comes out of the blue. Margarita pizza? Margarita pizza is good, but I don't prefer pizza. Really at all. My favorite pizza, if I get pizza, is just with pineapple and light cheese. The worst pizza I've ever had was the Costco cheese pizza because it's basically just all cheese. It's just cheese. But I don't know what else I don't like. It just comes out of nowhere. You know, people say something and I'm like, oh, I don't really like that. I don't like that very much. Do I like tofu? I do like tofu. What spices do I not like? I fucking hate buffalo sauce. Buffalo sauce sucks ass. It's like my least favorite thing in the whole wide world. Gross. It's literally just... It's nothing. It's nothing. It shouldn't even be a sauce. That's not picky. It's just bad. How's my spice tolerance? Reasonable, but not good. But that doesn't mean I'm picky. Buffalo sauce just tastes bad. Do you like ranch? Ranch is alright. It just depends what you're eating it with. Buffalo sauce isn't spicy. It's literally just nothing. Buffalo sauce is just vinegar. It's just vinegar with a slight, like, pepper taste. Barely. It's barely. It's bad. I'm sorry. Yeah, good buffalo sauce isn't, yeah, cope harder. It's not a bait opinion. I really don't like buffalo sauce. I don't care. You can say, oh, but butter, but I don't care. I don't like it. I think it's bad. But the butter. It's bad. And on that note, I'm not really a big fan of a lot of hot sauces because I don't think they taste good. The only hot sauce I really like is sriracha because it tastes like garlic. Yeah, and garlic makes everything better. Shout out to garlic. What about gochujang? I do like gochujang. I do. I feel like it has more, like, more flavor than than hot sauce. But I don't like buffalo. It's not bait. I just think it's bad. What else? What's my favorite sauce? Like, just overall for everything? That's crazy. I actually don't know. I do really like honey mustard, but I feel like honey mustard isn't as versatile as I want it to be. Like, ketchup is something you can put on everything. Well, honey mustard, I think honey mustard actually, I don't know. You can dip it in fries, you can put on salad, you can dip chicken, you can... No, I do like ketchup. Because I have a really bad sweet tooth. Oh, you don't like ketchup. Oh, man. That's crazy. What sauce for chicken nuggets? Honey mustard. Probably. Yeah, I really do like ketchup on my eggs. Ketchup on every breakfast food is good. Because it, like, mixes. Because, like, if you go to a diner and you put, like, ketchup on your eggs or, like, your potatoes or whatever, then, like, mixes and, oh, yeah. It's been a long time since I've had diner food, but it reminds me of being a kid, you know? Like a special going out in the morning treat on the weekends. Diner food is peak American experience. It was like one of the only cool things that we could do. And there was like a little diner. It was a fucking bar. It was a bar slash diner. And it was the closest thing near our house, and it smelled like fucking cigarettes, and it had, like, it had, like, these weird green faux leather seats that were peeling, and obviously they have Tabasco sauce on every single one of the tables, and it was kind of dirty and dingy, but damn, they make the biggest pancakes you'll ever see. We'll make the biggest pancakes you'll ever see. And as a kid, that's the most exciting thing in the whole wide world. Yeah, and the tray with the jams and the butter, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. But it's been a long time. Also, Nocturne, thank you for the resubscription. As an adult, I hate seeing big pancakes. Honestly, I probably wouldn't want my pancakes to be big either. I just feel like small pancakes are a little more fun. I don't know why. Weren't you sick yesterday? Yeah, and I still am. But I'm feeling a lot better. However, there is sweat dripping down my neck as we speak. But I'm feeling a lot better. Like, I'm not coughing as much and stuff. Yeah. No AC. No, everything's fine. It's just I have a really bad fever right now. That, it's alright. Silver, oh yeah, silver dollar pancakes, that's what they're called. I'm gonna make it, bro. I'm gonna make it. Cold sweat or normal sweat. It's like, I'm not, the only thing that's hot is my head, so it's just like, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. What was I gonna say? Oh, speaking of food, have you heard of Donut Daddy? Donut, huh? Donut, what? What is that? Why is everybody saying no? What is it? 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 You guys are exciting! Mean fuck Kingdom Steve. Mia, huh? Oh, thank you for finding me during Crab Game. Thank you. I had to leave early. What is Donut Daddy? What is that? Is that the guy that fucked a cake? What are you guys... What? What are you guys talking about? Please, please, please. Why am I not getting any con- Okay, here we go, thank you. Finally, a fucking link. It took like 5 minutes before someone was- Why are these all- He has a large Russian following. They like him. Look at that smirk emoji. Wow, he has a large Russian following. They like him. That was... The funny part is that sometimes he does these explainer videos and he just kind of awkwardly explaining his recipe and technical details.
So there we have it, our chocolate souffle recipe. Our chocolate souffle is super light and fluffy, made with a 70% dark chocolate. We've served that with creme anglaise, as well as Lotus Biscoff ice cream with Lotus Biscoff crumbs, raspberry puree swirls, freeze-dried raspberries dusted with cacao and snow sugar. You want to serve this hot, eat it within 10 minutes of coming out of the oven. We cut this open. We poured in some of that cream anglaise.
Dude, the worst part is he doesn't have to do this shit. He didn't need to do that. All he has to do is this. And I assure you that people would be fucking pounding at his door. This does not need to happen. Why does he do that? Why does he rub the egg like that? He wants to. Oh, I see. Oh, okay. My bad.
And then we shoved a nice, thick Lotus Biscoff right in.
The nice, thick Lotus Biscoff right in there.
In the center there. So I'm going to stick my face in this and enjoy it. So have a lovely day. So there we have.
Ooh. Did he fuck the chocolate souffle too? It's a ferret.
No. Okay, you don't have to. Ready?
Yeah, he fucked that souffle. So there we have it. Honestly, to be fair, I would totally fuck that souffle too. It looks good. He knows what he's talking about, it seems like. I mean, his food looks good. It really does. I would fuck that souffle. I totally would. Oh, it's my man who cooks on his bed.
Oh, hey there.
His really, really gross bed. Yeah. It's my man. What is that? No, just wait. You are asking what's this video, but you will see. I don't know what he's eating. He spit. Oh, okay. So that's him chewing up his ingredients. Oh, that's ginger. It's ginger. It's all of his spices. So he's making like a curry. So that's like the curry block. And so he's spitting it into this chicken. Yeah, he's mixing. And, And now he's frying it. This isn't even the worst one. I don't know why you guys are saying it's disgusting. I think this one was more tame than a lot of them. What, Ordinary Sausage is making soup videos now?
Sate.
Why is he?
そういうことね。そういうことね、クソ。
Look at his room. You guys should see where he keeps his meat. Just throw it on the bed. Oh yeah, he cooks most of his stuff on his bed too.
Yeah. これグラス？よいしょ。うわ。今回もボニョボニョしてますね。
It gives you really it like it shudders, makes your spine like shiver a little bit.At least, hey, look, at least he's making an effort to clean, right? Look at that. He's doing his best. Labba, thank you for the resubscription, motherfucker. Hey, are you guys good with me playing old school RuneScape tomorrow? Oh man, I... Oh shit, Darklord Dread, thank you for the 5 gift subs, motherfucker. Sponsored? No way, what the fuck? Thank you, motherfucker! Damn! Everybody be sure to... get on your knees and suck off the gift. The gifter. Am I playing with anyone? No, I'm not. Somebody in the beginning of the stream was talking about old school RuneScape, and they said, "When are you gonna play that?" And I said, "Tomorrow." So now I think I have to stick with it. Can I put STEM content on the side? No, I think old school RuneScape is epic. Would I be able to let you guys join me?
Follow me for 1 million, okay?
1 million followers? Bro! I gotta do my part. I gotta do my part. Let's fucking go. Okay, guys, remember to follow MariMar underscore yen for 1 million followers. I should start putting this whenever I put YouTube videos. Which is never. Whenever I make them, I should put this at the end. Give him a like for the engagement, you're right. Pop off. Time warp, wait, hold on. I need to do it manually because I fucked everything up and I don't know how to fix it. Would I try simulcast on YouTube and Twitch? I don't know. The issue is, I feel like it would be a lot to try and keep up with two different chats. So maybe I would do it with something where I don't interact with chat as much, but that's like my favorite thing to do, so then it just seems like kind of a moot point. And also, YouTube chat kind of sucks ass because it's delayed by like 50 billion hours. And also, Twitch is so good for interaction. It is so good. Twitch chat is so good. And the only reason I can appreciate it is because, as much as I love watching HoloLive Girls, or as much as I love watching my like Japanese brothers and sisters stream, I can't take the chat, and I can't really take. I don't like YouTube streaming. I really don't. Yeah, HoloLive chat is the worst. It really is. But yeah, it's especially noticeable when you're in like streamers' chats that have like a less active chat, you know? And then you're like typing and you don't see your message pop up for like 10 minutes. And you're like, oh. 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 Yeah, and also it seems like YouTube, as far as streaming goes, doesn't really have a good sense of community, if that makes sense. And rating is weird. They added rating, but it's like... YouTube is wonderful for what they set out to do, which was making videos. I'll say that. As far as a video streaming service, it's pretty good. Oh no. Oh no. Someone smeared my shit on the damn sidewalk. I'm a tumor. How'd that effect go off? I made it. Because somebody redeemed it and now it doesn't go off automatically anymore. Because I fucked everything up somehow. So now I have to do things manually with my hands. It's interesting to hear someone favor Twitch for streaming. You thought people prefer YouTube? Who are you talking to? Personally, almost everyone I talk to tends to favor Twitch streaming. The only issue is Twitch itself. I genuinely think that there are people who prefer YouTube like Pippa. Well, that's her business. That's her business. I think Twitch is more fun. I think Twitch... I mean... The thing about Twitch is it's great for interaction. It's great for extensions. Like, adding cool stuff on your stream. Having a good time. Making loud noises. I really enjoy it. I really do. I know I rag on Twitch a lot, but I do think that they do the streaming part well. Yeah. But I've considered doing streams on YouTube. It's just... I don't think I would like it. I really don't. Twitch ads can be annoying. Yeah, that's true. I've come to peace with the ads, I guess. I don't know how. I don't know. Maybe it's just because I stopped caring. Can't play marbles on YouTube. That is so true, but I can't even play it right now because every time I open it, it lags me the fuck out. Well, let me see. Maybe let me try to open it. We'll see how this goes. I'm a tumor. Oh no. What the fuck did they do to this game, bro? What did they do? Why does it make me go slow? There is not even an option for, like... I can't even adjust anything. It's just whenever I have it open, whenever I have it, there is not a graphics option. At least I can't find one. But whenever I have it open, even in like the backgrounds, it affects everything. I don't know why. Yeah, I'm gonna do Facebook gaming. Facebook gaming. That'll be good. Mark Zucky Wookie, invite me on your platform. Apparently, if you stream on Facebook gaming, you get 100% of the cut. But I don't even know how you monetize a Facebook stream. Like, where does that even come from? Does Amazon stream still? I hate to break it to you, but Twitch is their streaming platform. Twitch is owned by Amazon. If you want Amazon streaming, you're coming to Twitch. Don't you use your real name on Facebook? Me personally, I don't even have a Facebook account anymore. So VTubers can't see my name. But if I streamed on Facebook, then I would probably see all of your guys' real names. And that would be... Yeah, it might be a little bit weird. Hey there, Dave. Yeah. Joe. That would be weird. Thanks, Craig, for the $50 donation. I think you can lie about your name on Facebook. You already know my real name. I do not know your real name. I really don't. If you think we close like that, we not close like that. I do not know your real name. Candle. We not close like that. Sometimes I see your guys' names on my merch orders, but I don't know. I don't know who any of them go to. So I know of, I've seen some names before. Oh yeah. What was I gonna say? I don't trust like that. Open that button. No, I don't want to smell man filth. Yeah, no, I write down all of your guys' full names and address in my journal just for safekeeping. Just in case. So if one of you guys ever makes fun of me or hurts my feelings, then... I will come after you. Yeah, sorry. Even if I've seen any of your guys' names before, I do not remember them. Which is probably a good thing. You don't want some random crazy bitch to know your full name and address. I assure you. My name is Zingus. Yeah, I am the daughter of the Unabomber after all. I don't, you don't. My name is Jeff. Thank you guys, thank you. I still can't believe everybody gaslit Grimmy into thinking that the Unabomber was actually my dad. And when I came into her stream, she wholeheartedly told me, "I'm so sorry for your loss." Grimmy. Grimmy. You poor sweet summer child, Grimmy. I think I would have bigger problems than my dad dying if everybody knew that my dad was the Unabomber and I was a VTuber at the same time. Grimmy. She's silly. She's silly. I'm not that crazy though. Man, I'm tired. Bean Curds, thank you for the free subscription. I'm a god's silliest VTuber. I'm so silly, I put the pipe bomb in your mailbox. Surely it isn't the fever. It's okay. You thought that was me farting? What? I wish my farts were that consistent, dude. If I had farts that sounded the exact same every single time, I could have a career. I don't know what kind of career, but I could have one for sure.
Princess Sandy Lowe.
Literally me!
After a long day of moch maxing, it's important to be an EP pilled sleep soul.
I'm so glad these are still going strong.
Rest well, Princess Sandy Loam.
Mulch Gang for life.
Mulch Gang for life.
Princess Sandy.
This one has only 48 likes. It's hot off the presses. Why did you subscribe to a lie? Wait, what? A lie? Why am I not reviewing Sailor Venus Dojin right now? Probably because I respect the fuck out of my women. Probably because I respect the fuck out of it. Okay? Probably because me and my Dojin is between her and me and God and nobody else, and I'm a God-fearing woman who cares about my virtual 2D wives. Well, you think I'm just gonna go around flaunting? That's unholy. Unholy. I would never do that to one of the most beautiful girls in the whole wide world. Sailor Venus from the Sailor Moon series. The skin cream that attracts spiders? No, but I almost wanted to, get the Panera lemonade today. I almost wanted to. I was thinking about it, and it was on my mind, and I was like, I'm kind of hungry, and I was scrolling through foods. And someone got me an Uber Eats gift card, so I was like scrolling. And there was Panera, and I was like, wouldn't it be fucking awesome if I got the Panera lemonade? And I was like, nah. Damn, Ray! Damn! Put some fucking respect on that, bro! I appreciate it. Thank you. You and I, we have something in common. We both love blonde-haired bitches. I'm glad I can be a good role model. Okay, Sam! Okay! Thanks! Another one. Yeah, you feel blessed to be a blonde bitch? Blonde bitches bless up. Okay. It's more fun to be blonde. It really is. I grew up being a dumb, dirty blonde, but I went all the way. I got that shit bleached. I'm a bottle blonde, baby. My mom said, she said, blondes have more fun anyways. And I think it might just be because the bleach seeps through your skull. So every single time I get it redone, I probably get stupider and stupider. Do you guys want to hear my new favorite song right now? Wait, hold on. Ever since we listened to Guilty Gear music, I listen to the same song every single day. Because I love it, and it makes me feel really badass when I'm walking anywhere. Look, this is the best song I've ever heard in my life. Okay, sorry, I stopped. This is the best song. It's so cool, it's got... Would I drink pond water? Yeah. I drink any water. People make fun of me because I'm a sink water bitch. Oh, some gay shit. Yeah, some gay shit! Yeah, I'm all about that. I wish I was him. I wish I was Kai. I wish I had a 3-year-old wife, dude. Yeah. I don't know why people are so... You know how I know that people are babies? Okay? If you tell me that you can't stand the taste of sink water, grow up! Grow up! Bitch! Shut cold sink water at the night? You run in, you're like so thirsty. You ever wake up in the middle of the night and you're like, and you're just so thirsty. And you run to the sink and you can't find a cup. And so you just, blah, 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 you put your head under the faucet and you just let it go in. And it's cold, it's the coldest water you've ever drank in. And it hits the spot. And it almost gives you a little bit of a headache. Like a brain freeze. It's like the most amazing feeling. Yeah, you feel like a fucking beast. It's awesome. Give me the fluoride. Give me the gay chemicals. I don't need my testosterone anyways. It's me and my 3-year-old wife. To the end. Yeah. Waterboarding yourself is liberating. Yeah, it's the closest you'll ever feel to a bison. Honestly, it's the closest you'll ever feel to, like... You guys ever see, like, those kung fu movies and to, like, train? They stand underneath a waterfall? Literally me. Literally me in the middle of the night. Look at this! Isn't this image... If I saw this image when I was younger, I would have went to the library right now. I would have seen this and I would have been like, oh my god. And I would have gone to the library and I would have printed this out in black and white. And I would have taped it to my fucking door. I would do this and I would have been like, he is just like me for real. And I would have stared at this every single day. And I would have prayed. I would have prayed to God every single night. And I would have said, dear God, please, I wish I was Kai Kisk from Guilty Gear. He's literally Marth-coded. This guy's Marth-coded, and I did that for Marth. Yeah. I love Faust. I like Faust. But Faust is the kind of guy you hold hands with, you know? Not the kind of guy you swear to become. Yeah. Wait, what is this? Put this jam. Desolation Row by My Chemical Romance. I want to be Kai. If I could be any Guilty Gear character... I would want to be Kai. Or maybe, why am I so out of the way? Why am I, like, over here? It looks like I'm hiding from you guys. Oh, I'm scared. You guys smell. Ew. Did he shower yet today? Please dominate the screen. I woke up to the sight and these sounds, I'd assume I'd die. When I was younger, one time, I was like alone at home and I was in my room and I was like fucking zoinked out. I don't know what my deal was, but it was like the morning and I was playing fucking Sims Bustin' Out on the GameCube at like 9 a.m. And on the other side of my door, all of a sudden, I heard giggling and like knocking, and in my head I immediately thought, oh my god, the angels came to take me away, I finally died. But when I opened the door, it was just my aunt and my cousin. I didn't even recognize the voices. I genuinely thought that I died. Why would I ever think that? Because... Zooted. I'm zooted in the brain. I just want you guys to know, I've never done recreational drugs. But I've been accused several billion times on stream by random chat members of being high. I've never done marijuana. And to be honest with you, I probably never would. I'm just professionally regarded. Yeah, I am straight edge. It doesn't seem like it. But... give me a drug test any time of the day. It will always come back positive. I don't even eat poppy seeds, so that's not an issue. I would probably want to be Faust. He's kind of cool. Ow! Ugh! My bones! My bones. They break and they crack. Honestly, Faust's theme doesn't go as hard as I want it to. Wait, actually this part goes. Oh, red, red and black. Okay, oh, I remember this now. Okay, yeah. No, this one is good actually. Okay, I remember it. I just didn't remember the beginning part. Why does it always come back to Guilty Gear? Maybe I should just, like, kick the bucket. I mean... rip the band-aid off. Sorry. Yeah, rip the band-aid off and play Guilty Gear for more than 18 minutes. Or, no, it was 17, wasn't it? I played Guilty Gear for a total of 17 minutes and all of that was in the menus. 18 minutes? Yeah, I gotta kick the bucket now. I guess. I also really like Milia's theme. I really do. But fighting games are really hard. Because you have to work. And honestly, I don't want to. The only thing I want to do is play Mario and be bad at it. Because that's what I love. That's my favorite thing. And now we have this very wistful part. Just be the Joker. I'm the Joker, baby. Sim racing. You know, I want to play more racing games. I think they're fun. But my favorite racing game, oh my god. You can't even believe how excited I was when I found out that they're redoing Crazy Taxi. Sega is so bad. We're so fucking back. And I was giving them shit. Okay? I was giving them shit. I was like, no way. Sega is nothing. All they care about is Yakuza and Sonic. And they don't care about any of their old franchises at all. And then they were like, no, hold on. We actually do. And here's one of your favorite games of all time. They're really stringing me along. I do like to paint my nails. I want to get... What color should I get next time? I have, like, sparkly... You know, the navy and white and sparkly ones. Maybe I should get, like... Ooh, I punched my microphone. Blue, red, and black. Faustcore. Meet and fuck Kingdom, Steve. I kind of want to get pink. For the New Year's. No, that doesn't make any sense. For Valentine's Day. Duh! Pink for Valentine's Day. Sega Pachinko. Madoka. Maguka. Madoka Pachinko. I want to play that. I want to play that Madoka machine where you put your finger on it and she gets shy. Ironclad Faith. Ironclad Faith. Wait. Is that here? No, it's not. I like Milia's theme, though. Okay, Donut Daddy, don't call me that. I never want to see that in my eyes again. Which is a shame, because his food looked so good. But if I have to watch him finger any more dough, I'm probably gonna cry. Why did he have to do that with the egg? Like, I can't get it out. Now I'm thinking about it. And I can't get it out of my head. It wasn't even that bad. Okay. Man. Grow a vagina and come back and tell me it's not that bad. Alright. You can come back. You'll feel differently. It's not... The other ones were worse. You're on? I'm not challenging you! Why are you telling me like it's a challenge? Like, oh yeah. No. It's the fruit that was the worst. The fruit? The fruit? What fruit? The fruit? Was there one with fruit? Oh my fucking god. I picked the tamest one of his videos. I didn't pick it, someone else did. Twist it, lick it, dunk it. I don't know. How bad do you want Santa to come? What? Look at him go. Yeah, this is white culture, that's so true. What? No, come on! That was so weird.
You could get a lot of dietary fiber from our wholemeal bread if we ate one or two slices like this with every meal. And a lot of proteins, vitamins,
this
and
doesn't feel
food.
Anywhere near as
but
sexual.
It has to be wholemeal bread.
What is that then? What is that then, huh?
You could get a lot of dietary fiber.
That's a man slicing.
We get one or two slices like this with every meal.
Yeah, I'm slicing too.
But it has to be wholemeal bread, not brown or wheat.
That's what EDP was talking about.
White bread,
that's what he was doing. That's what EDP was just slicing some bread. That's all. He really was just getting a cupcake. That's what Dark Side Phil was doing on stream. It's alright. He shouldn't have been banned. He was just slicing some bread. How not to make bread. Why, ever since I watched this video, I keep getting recommended DJ Khaled to me. He used to be a human being. What, this is him? He's just playing piano. He's had this account for so long. What the fuck? And he just decided to come back as a horny baker? And look at him now. Oh, he's still playing piano, except naked. Naked the first time around? To be fair, no. Well, yeah, you can see he's wearing a shirt. So I can tell you for a fact that he's not naked here. Kinda sad. I don't think there's anything sad about this. I don't think there's a single sad thing about this. It's just weird. There's nothing sad about him playing piano when he was 17 and now playing piano 14 years later without a shirt. Why doesn't he lick the piano? I don't know. There's nothing. He could choose to not be a horny freak with food. Well, you could say that about a lot of people, but to be frank, then we'd have to tell everybody to stop consuming. Like, if there's a market, then people are gonna need to fill it. And so he found his niche, and now. Don't look. I swear to God, it's not what you think. Who has a healthier relationship with food, King Ass Ripper or Donut Daddy? Well, if I'm being honest with you, Donut Daddy seems to have a perfectly fine relationship with food. Like, it seems like he's very in tune with his food, both romantically and... You know, and, you know, and you know, you can see it. you for the raid. I hope you're... Oh, I really don't like that. Listen, I'm not trying to justify this. I just want to put this out there. I'm not trying to justify this. I'm just saying that we are being a little bit... dumb. Okay, maybe we don't like it, and that's fine. But we can't say it doesn't have a right to exist. And this is how I have to go thinking about OnlyFans girls every day. Because people will always buy. And I just know all those Russian girls in his comments, that's his niche. They like him. Yeah. Bye. Yeah. Kopa! Thank you for the 15 gift subs, motherfucker. I hope you get 15 bro jobs from chat. Why am I thinking about OnlyFans every day? Probably because I am a VTuber and every single time I go on Twitter, I have to see somebody shilling their OnlyFans. So, yeah. Because I literally live on the internet and it's like the only, it's like I have to think about it every day. Can we please watch something else? Put up or shut up then! What do you want to watch? What is this? Also, I've had to think a lot about it because oh my god, what the fuck? So, when, if you're MariMari underscore Yen, you live with a lot of shame, and oftentimes, you guys ever have those feelings pop up? When, like, you think about something that happened in the past that really embarrassed you, but nobody thinks about anymore. And then it just, like, wakes you up and you feel really uncomfortable. That's how I feel every single time I think about that incident when I was sitting in an Uber and the guy asked me what I did for work. And I said that I'm a content creator and he asked me OnlyFans, right? And then I said, haha, no, and it was silent for the entire car ride home. So that's why I have to think about OnlyFans every single day. I genuinely don't know why he thought that was okay. To this very day, I still don't understand why he thought it was okay to say, and every single time I look in the mirror, I have to ask myself, do I look like a whore? every single day. So, yeah. Maybe it's because I'm blonde. I'm just gonna assume that. I'm just gonna assume it's just because I'm blonde. I'm crossing my fingers. He was just stupid. Why would you think that's a good thing to say to someone random in your car? Why? I don't know. Yeah, so I think about it all the time. Yeah. Maybe that was his only understanding of content creator. He could have asked me if I do YouTube. He could have asked, I said online content creator. He could have asked me, he could have said, oh, you do YouTube, right? Not, haha, OnlyFans, right? Wow. Wait, this is A and B compilation. Oh, it's just some epic fighting. Porn addicts. Did I watch AMV Hell? Are they still making AMV Hell? Or are you asking me that as like a catch 22, like gotcha, now I know you're old because you know what AMV Hell is. Now I'm sad.
Ah, man.
How to grill a steak without a grill. Wait, is this the guy that starts a fire in his house?
I'm making some steak. Got the frozen steak here. I read on a message board that apparently trying to cook steak on a pan with oil is kind of some kind of a crime or something. So we're gonna try it with a grill.
Look at that.
This
honestly, my favorite fucked up food YouTuber is Dino Tendies. Oh, what? Oh, shit, you read my mind! What? No shit! No shit! That's crazy. Happy Halloween. Pet a possum eating. Yeah, he just feeds his possum. That's awesome. It's just like a bull bear. I really don't like what you sent me, but I feel obligated to watch it all because he's staring at me and it has that caption at the top. Oh my god. Frat boy singing Bach. He sure was. Yeah. He does sound like a cello. Like the way his voice goes, it actually kind of does sound like a cello. Which is funny because the original suite is for cello. Yeah, it is. Why are his hands like that? I don't know. John Whitney Matrix. IBM. Irritable bowel movements. John Whitney. What the fuck is this? This reminds me of when you're watching a VHS tape and in the beginning, it has all those, like, it has, like, that blue screen. Before the movie. I honestly think that if I could go back in time, I would want to play the cello instead. Because I think the cello is probably one of the best instruments. Period. I know that's like a bold take, but it's a good one. Yeah, then you'd have to carry it around. Normie core? Okay, well, maybe then it's normie for a reason. You know, I've had to think about that. I've had to think about that a lot because I used to be like a really bad hipster. And then when I found myself liking normie things, I was like, oh no. But then I thought, wait, this is normie for a reason. Why not now? Sometimes I still am. I'm fighting the urge every day to say that I liked things before they were cool. truly. Wait, you know what's funny about this? I thought that this was just a starting screen for a video that we were about to watch. But this is the video. I'm putting this in the back. Yeah, a lot of popular things are popular because they're good. What are my thoughts on Neutral Milk Hotel? Music like that is for sad indie girls. I don't know what you want from me. I mean, yeah, it could be white man music, but this is nice. I do enjoy this, whatever this is. King Gizzard the Lizard Wizard. King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. Is 100 Gex cool yet? I think they're less cool than they were, like, a year ago, actually. I think you missed your opportunity. This is what 100 Gex sounds like. Sticking out your gap for the Rizzler, you're so skibbity, and then there's like really random, like, there's random like noises like, this is what 100 Gex sounds like, and then there's like, yeah, and pitched up. You haven't listened to Gex in a while then. Yeah, no, I'm not really. To be fair, I don't really keep up with 100 Gex. Yeah, not really a Gex head, sorry. It's fucking art. You don't understand. Your feeble woman mind would never understand true art. That makes me holier than thou. I don't even know what my favorite band would be right now. I feel like all of these bands, this is gonna sound weird, but this is like Spotify core, you know what I mean? And I don't use Spotify. People who use Spotify are on a different level. But I personally think that Spotify is stealing your money. What is Spotify core? It's like, I don't know how to explain this, but it's like music that my friends back home would listen to, and they're insufferable, like, I don't even know how to explain it. They do this thing called, Music League. It's called Music League, and you have to use Spotify for it. And, they do, like, different, categories, and everybody submits a song for the category, and everybody listens to the playlist that was created, and they rank all of the songs. And whoever gets the highest rankings by the end wins. It's pretty fun, but that and like, God, what's her name? Fiona Apple. Is that her name? Fiona? What's her name? What the fuck is this? You just started to use Spotify? Honestly, Spotify is... unfortunate. It's like a necessary evil. I just think it's way overpriced for what it is. And one thing that frustrates me is artists don't get paid for having their shit on Spotify. Spotify is stealing from people, like, unironically. And if you can't use it for free. It's impossible to use it for free. You just can't. So it's just a trap. And everybody uses Spotify, so you think, oh, the only way I can share music is through Spotify. Yeah. $10 a month is only expensive in Africa. That is, like, the stupidest thing I think you could have ever possibly said. Consider all of the other subscription services that you quote-unquote need to have, and all of your unfortunately expensive groceries, and your insane rent, because everything is super fucking expensive for no reason. If you, honestly, if you get YouTube Music and you just have that, fine. But YouTube Music is still too much for what it is. It is still way too much for what it is. Do you guys want to know how much YouTube Premium costs if you don't already? It costs 19 bucks a month. It's not 15. They updated it. Yeah. It costs 19. They increased it. Yeah, no, go look. It costs 19 bucks a month. You can get YouTube Music for like $10, and for YouTube Premium, it costs 19. And you wanna know how I know this? Because I checked recently. I checked recently. How much is Spotify? I think it's like $13 a month. Which is still stupid. Still so dumb. Loops. This is fart noises. It's more expensive if you look at it on Apple devices. Wait, what? You cannot tell me that it's $5 more expensive because I was looking at my iPhone. No fucking shot! That is so fucked up, bro! $5 more? Just because I was looking on iPhone? Dude. I'm gonna grill myself. So I guess if you buy YouTube Premium on iPhone, it's $19. That's crazy. Don't buy it on iPhone. Oh yeah, also, well, Twitch subscriptions are just more expensive on mobile in general because either Apple or Google will take a portion. So, yeah. That sucks. Google takes less. I think they both take $1. Because I'm pretty sure when you subscribe to somebody on Google, either way, it's $5.99 instead of $4.99. Which is... No, yeah, if you have subs on mobile, you should definitely switch them. For sure. Normal McLaren. Oh, Norman McLaren. A normal McLaren. These videos are crazy. Cute. Classic video and Gex.
剣の道に入って5年になる私だが、さすがは師匠。こちらに背中を向けても踏み込めないオーラがある。まるで後ろにも目があるかのようだ。
I wanna get a pet.
師匠。
I want a duck. I want a duck so bad. Do we have a house cat? It's not my cat. Would I name said duck? I would get two ducks. I would get a brown duck and I would get a white one. And I would name one strudel, and I would name one brioche. I'm pissing in the breeze. Pissing in the wind! Of course I know duck shit a lot. All birds do. I'm a bird person. I've had many of birds. I do not care if they shit. At least they shit. I don't shit. I feel happy for them. Worst bird. Not magpies. I love magpies. Emus are weird. I like seagulls, actually. I like seagulls. Emus, though, I don't really like them. Duck. Aww. Oh, it's Wrinkle! It's Wrinkle! Wrinkle the duck? This guy takes his duck to like this guy took his duck to the Hello Kitty cafe and a Target, and he just makes videos about bringing his duck to different places.
Hi, Wrinkle.
Look at him. Somebody asked if ducks are aggressive, and they're definitely not aggressive.
You know what a marathon is?
Ducks are not aggressive. You might geese can get aggressive though. Geese can be definitely aggressive, but that's why people train them to be guard animals for their farms. Geese is a good guard animal. Yeah, geese are fucked up. Canadians know. Fuck Canada. That's where all the geese are. Canada's where. That's
Thank
why.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Hey, good luck, guys.
Canadians are bottom bitches because the geese, they flex on them and they assert their dominance. You guys know that brand Canada Goose? This is kind of besides the point, but don't buy what they're peddling, okay? Don't buy what they're peddling. I don't care how cool and rich you'd feel if you wore one of their coats. You do not, and I repeat, you do not buy a $2,000 coat when you could get a same exact coat for like $200 somewhere else. Okay. You already own one? It is so freaking over! Mary! Mary, hi! I had so much fun on the crab game. I had so much fun. I left early though, I'm sorry, because I've been sick. I've been ill, but I'm good. I'm just sweating a lot because I have a fever. But I had fun, and I liked it. But I was mean. I was mean. And I didn't even win one. But I'll win one next time. More duck?
Oh, more ducks?
Yeah, go on Taobao. Go on Temu. Wait, don't listen to me say those things. Don't do that. Because it's cruel. No, don't buy from the Temu and Shein. Don't do that. It's underpaid labor. Bad for you. Bad.
Hello.
Don't buy
I'm
it.
Landon Ashworth, curator and head of the Board of Tourism.
This is about Montana?
Montana. And I bet you think
that's
you know
from where that. I was at.
In Montana, everyone sounds like I do. We call it a Montanian accent. Is a homage to this.
It's almost impossible
name,
to buy a coat
Montana,
that isn't plastic junk in 2023.
The bringer of
coat, guys. You are a fool. You are such a fool. There's so many places to go buy a coat. There's so many places. What is the big Montana coat? Men's coats? Uniqlo is a great place to buy a coat. For what it, for the cost of Uniqlo coat for what you get is oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Yes, 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 yes. I really like Patagonia. I also like Patagonia. Oh, 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 oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Look at them eat it. They're so fast. They're so fast at it. Should have been a duck princess. Honestly, sometimes I wonder about that. If I ever reincarnated, I feel like I would have been a duck because I am honk like one and I'm loud like a duck. But I don't know why I'm a fish. I think I would be a great duck. Yeah. Yeah, the magic. The magic. Do you believe in afterlife? Ducks aren't evil, and I'm not evil either. Patagonia is good. Colombia makes some good coats. I don't know what you mean by plastic junk, though. I don't know what you mean. I wouldn't buy anything like polyester. Who's buying? Just look at the what it's made out of. Honestly, in my humble opinion, just make sure it's durable and warm. So make sure it has like nice interior and a good strong exterior. Like, that's all. Go to a sporting brand, sports brand. Don't buy your coat at fucking H&M. Don't do it. Don't buy from H&M, period. Overpriced, and your clothes is gonna break in 2 days.
Spatula. Hey, did you let Roxy eat the mushrooms?
This duck is high on mushrooms. This duck is high on mushrooms and its name is Spatula. That is so funny.
Spatula. Hey,
if you sign this contract with
mushrooms?
Throne, would you use it? Wait,
go
what
them,
throne
Roxy.
Contract?
Go get him.
What's the contract?
You should stop eating those, honey. They don't agree with you.
I'll sign anything.
Man, they should send their
Grom wants to partner with Luid for 30%. Dude. Here, I'm gonna make you it. Well, why don't you just negotiate? Why don't you negotiate, though?
Did you? Do you remember last time when your legs were
wooden? Did you try?
And you walked like a pirate?
Just say, go to Throne and be like, hey, look, there's a lot of VTubers who use this platform, and I cater directly toward VTubers, so I think that I would be a greater asset to you, and say that you want, like, more. Demand a higher percentage. Like, you don't need to be complacent. Yeah, you go, girl.
Co-fito,
what is
which
this?
Is Montanian for Tabidi do Johanna, which is Cherokee for glacier, which is French for cat, and cat is Chinese for food.
But if you were partnered with Throne, I would show your products. The only creators who use it will cost 30%. I see. Interesting. Wait, what happened? Why is everybody cringing?
Tabidi do Johanna, which is Cherokee for glacier, which is French for cat, and cat is Chinese for food.
Oh, I don't like that. This video sucks ass. Whoever sent this deserves to die. Just kidding.
Potato canishes.
Potato canishes. I love potato canishes. This machine creates potato canishes.
This is where I make potato canishes.
When all else fails, I'll always come back to Rat Boy Genius. You make me so happy. Man, my throat is hurting. Here, let me get some water. You guys can watch this. Wait, it's gonna stop soon. Wait, hold on. You can watch it. Hold on. What do you watch?
This is where I make Santa.
You watch it.
I'm the Glub Glow Gabgala. I love books. And this basement is a true treasure trove. I am the glob glow gab galab, the schwabble dabble wabble gabble flibber blabber blab. I'm full of schwibble glibber kind. I am the yeast of thoughts and mind. Schwabble dabble glibber glabber schwibble schwab glab. Dibble double schwibble shabble glibber glab schwab. Schwabble dabble glibber glabber schwibble schwab dab. Dibble double schwibble shabble glibber schwab glab. Ooh,
ha ha ha. Oh my god.
Splendid.
Splendid.
Simply delicious.
I am the glub glub gub galab,
the schwabble double wabble gabble flibber blabber blab. I'm full of schwibble glibber kind. I am the yeast of thoughts and mind. Schwabble double glibber glabber schwibble schwab glab. Dibble double schwibble schwabble glibber glab schwab. Schwabble double glibber glabber schwibble schwab glab. Dibble double schwibble schwabble glibber schwab glab.
That was fast. What is this?
Yo, what up, guys? Lanky Kong.
Wait,
here.
Kanye sampled that? Stop sending this. Stop sending it to me. I have opened this video on stream at least 5 times. Stop. Stop. None more of it. You guys need to expand your mind. It's time to find new videos. We cannot live in the past any longer. We need to go forward. Actually, this one goes hard though. We can listen to this though. What is this? Compass. What are we watching? I love Sim. People are such babies. Stop telling me soup is bad. It's really good. Look at those boobs. Literally you after you eat soup. See, that's why you guys are all soy boy cucks. Because you don't eat soup. You don't like soup. You say, oh, my soup isn't even that good. How the fuck is soup not even that good? It's so good. You can make any kind of soup you want. You drink soup. You don't eat it. Fuck you. Chicken noodle soup. What do? You eat it. What are you gonna fucking do? Drink chicken, stupid? You eat it and you drink it. It's a food and a soup. It's a food and a drink. It's a soup and a soup. You eat and you drink. It's literally called chicken noodle soup. Not every soup is just water. Not every soup is just liquid. Not every soup is tomato soup. But you wanna know what? Tomato soup also goes hard. Because it tastes good. And it tastes like basil and creamy and tomato. Chicken and leek soup goes so hard. It does. Tomato soup. Yeah. If we consider all soups, they're either liquid plus chunks or just liquid. Yeah, and so what? If you consider all food is all chunks. So, like, what's your fucking point? It's all just chunks. Is cereal a soup? No, because it's not cooked first. Even cold soup is cooked first. It's just served cold. But I like cereal, though. I do. Yeah, I like... Curry is a soup, then. Yeah, you can make a curry soup. Yeah. Yes. I've had a curry chicken, like a chicken curry noodle soup, like a Vietnamese curry chicken noodle soup before. And it was really, really good. And if you ate that and you told me after that the soup is bad, I would probably strangle you to death. And throw your body off a bridge into water where it would become bloated. And when you got found, nobody could recognize you because you were bloated by all the water and the hypothermia. Gross. Cheese soup? I don't like cheese. Oh, she's so cute. I'm scaring your cats good.
I like you. Come over to my house and hug my sister.
Yeah! I wish I had a sister too, so I could fuck her. I don't know why I said that. Please just forget it. I was excited. I was thinking about anime. I was thinking about anime. I don't feel that way. That's not a Freudian slip. I literally just said it. That's not a slip. That's not a slip. I just said. With my whole chest. Where's the Freudian and where's the slip? I said what I said. It wasn't a slip. I just said it. Because I thought it would be funny. But then when I said it out loud, it wasn't funny because I said it too real. Because it wasn't a joke, I just said it out loud like that, and there wasn't any punchline. And I just said that, and now everybody's gonna think I wanna fuck a sister. Yeah. It is a dumb comment. That's what I'm good for, I'm a VTuber. I watch things, and then I say things without thinking, that's all we do. That's it. That's only it. You haven't seen a Rimo? Of course I've seen a Rimo. I've seen a lot of anime about fucking your sister. Am I closing these tabs? No. I don't even have that many tabs open, though. It's not even that bad. Like, that's only maybe 20. That's not bad! If you think that's bad, then you are... Well... You're but a baby right from the womb. Ultimate Muscle Roller Legend. Oh my god! I love this video! This is so real!
Stupid.
You don't even know anything. You don't even know anything. But me, I know everything because I know a lot about Vocaloid. So clearly that means that I'm the leading authority in knowledge and everything. I am very smart. What is with the YouTube algorithm lately? I feel like more often than not, I've been getting recommended really recent one view videos on YouTube. Which is kind of fun. If this wasn't an AI cover, I guess.
No one to get in our way. Ocelots are proud creatures. They prefer to hunt alone.
Sora, did you mean to send me your entire playlist of... Now, all right, let's see what kind of music you like to listen to. Atmospheric breakcore DNB mix. I want to look into the minds of my thin cells. Yeah, let's open a stash. Let's see what this guy goons to. This kind of goes to sleep. I like, is project management career,
welcome,
is it right for
back
me?
To the very first episode of the PM Perspective channel.
Yeah, I feel I know. Like we're learning a lot about you.
There. They've been out there for a few years. This is exactly the first episode. But I'm calling it the first episode because this is the first regular episode that I'll be putting out there. So I'm just celebrating the moment. So today, yeah. Actually, before we get into today's topic, I just want to say or remind you that
for
the remainder of March and for April, our topic of discussion is going to be all about how to get a project management job. If you have never had a project management job before,
Joker is a billionaire.
First one, then I've got lots of stuff this month that will be relevant for you that you'll find interesting. And if you have a project management job, but you're maybe looking for that next opportunity, there's going to be plenty of great stuff for
Look
you as well. So if you're in either one of those
KK
situations,
earthquake.
There's a lot of really great information that I'll be sharing
awesome
with you over the next few weeks.
If I'm being
Today's
honest
topic
with you.
Is, I think it's apropos. It's,
this stuff
it's,
kinda
it's
goes
answering
really
the question,
hard.
Is project management
like,
right for me? And so it is a little more geared towards the person who is looking to break into project
Where
management who
it?
Hasn't had that job before. What I want to cover today,
Why Archie
we'll start
Sonic
with talking
is the best
about
Sonic
some of the
character
typical
analysis.
Reasons people say they want to get into
and
project
And I like
management.
The Dragon Ball Yamcha and Power Creep in Dragon Ball FighterZ. You know, I've never played this game before. Oh man, you know what? Wait, hold on. Sorry guys, I need to ignore you for a little bit because I'm gonna go on Fortnite without your consent. And hold on. Well, hold on. Because I don't know, because I think today is the last day for Goku Black and Cell and Frieza, actually. And so I think I need to spend money. But you already have Peter. I know, but like, what if I was Goku Black? Because like, what if though? What if I was Goku? Because everybody was tagging me in this post that Pippa made, and it was like, I only play Fortnite with girls with big boobs, and it made me sad, but then a VTuber came and said, it's okay, I'll play Fortnite with you, and I said, I got gold Peter Griffin, and she said, that's so badass, so now I really want to impress her, and maybe we can play together, and if I have, like, Goku Black and Peter Griffin and, like, Frieza and stuff, then, like, I don't know. Then I'll probably be, like, the sexiest person to any VTuber. Yeah. But don't tell them I don't have Peter Gold yet. I don't have Peter Gold. I only have regular Peter Griffin. But I will get it before. But they don't need to know that. I just wanted to sound cool, so I said I have gold Peter Griffin, and I lied. I lied, but... But I will have gold Peter Griffin. When does the item shop reset? In 14 hours? Guys, okay, I need an opinion. What's better? Goku Black or Frieza or Cell? Can we get a poll? Do I even have a mod here? I don't know if I have any mods. Because I'm stupid and I decided to stream at 11:14 p.m. Oh yeah, Garfield, can you make a poll for Goku Black or Frieza or Cell? Wait, he has a transforming emote? Wait, for real? Goku Black Bundle has Key Scythe, Key Sword, Goku Black charging up. Wait, am I allowed? Can I use this emote on other characters too? Or is it a built-in emote? No. Only for Goku Black? No. That's so sad. But he does come with the sword and the scythe. So that's pretty cool. Also, Frieza gets Golden Frieza. Oh yeah, and Cell gets Perfect Cell, right? Aw, shit, now this has made it really difficult. But Frieza and Cell don't get pickaxes bundled. Man! How much is it for all of them? 2,300 plus 1,800. What's 2,300 plus 1,800? That's, like 4,000? So $41. No, it's like 35. Just buy the $80 V-Bucks pack. Do you really think I should? It's $90. Dude, that would be crazy. You know what? I'm putting this down. I'm putting down Fortnite. I'm gonna sleep on this because this is what I have to do. I have to tell myself. Yeah, Lord Sugar Dong, thank you for the resubscription. I told myself that I wouldn't buy anything after 10 p.m. anymore. And I haven't really been doing a good job at that, but I told myself that I wouldn't. And now I'm going to not. Now I'm gonna stop. I'm going to sleep on it. Because people get impulsive at the odd hours of the night.
Then they really.
Vegeta. I want Freeze. I mean, I want Vegeta.
Vegeta. You fool.
Yeah. Oh my god. Wait, bring Nenik over.
Where is he taking him?
Stand in front of me. Like that. Nah, don't look at me. Watch this.
Come on! on, dude.
9000SLAYER tipped 40 美元. We gonna get you that gold, Peter Murray.
Come on, dude. Come on, dude. Come on, come on. Dude. Well, maybe it's okay to buy things after... Maybe it's okay to buy things after 10 p.m. if somebody kind from chat funded it, right? Stop enabling me! Stop it! Stop! It's okay to buy every single Dragon Ball character in Fortnite, actually. Yeah, I mean, if it's a gift, then... I mean... How can I say no? The very... What is this? Noob Sama, thank you for the raid. Welcome in, everybody. My name is Marimar underscore Yen. Is your profile picture Pekora? How the fuck was Halo? How was that for you? I hope you didn't say any gamer words to underage children.
It's shaping up to be one.
Don't do that. Malding but fun. That's good. Pekora would never. Pekora would never. She's a good one. But yeah, welcome in there. What?
Anonymous tipped 2 美元, twisting my arm with extortion bot, okay goldfish.
Huh? Thank you for the $2. Isn't Pekora a big gambler? To be fair, a lot of VTubers are big gamblers. My Oshi, who is dead, rip Otajibara, she was the biggest gambler I knew. I have never seen any VTuber spend more money on gacha in one stream than her. And for a really, really, really long time. And I loved her for that. I loved her. And when she finally got what she wanted, she would make the most beautiful monkey noises you could ever imagine. The bowling alley screen when you get... Oh, I love videos like this. Why do all my Oshis graduate? It's too soon. You make fun of my Canadian goose jacket, but support gambling? Yes. Canadian goose is stealing your money! Canada goose, fuck 'em! Listen, listen, listen. If there's one thing I know, it's about clothes. All right. What am I watching? Clothes are stupid. You would be a great VTuber. Almost every single VTuber I know has admitted to streaming most of the time. Did he just die himself? Anyways, VTubers always admit to streaming with no clothes on. Maybe you should take up VTubing. What are these? What is this channel? Mystery. Mystery. Digilux, the end of the beginning? What is this? What is this? soup? Is their penis tracking yet? I've seen some unfortunate things. I've seen some unfortunate things. I've had somebody show me a model. I've had somebody show me a 2D model that could... Oh, I don't even want to say it. It's so embarrassing. It had... You guys know how VTubers have, like, fun toggles? Like, they can hold cups of tea or whatever, or, like, laugh or whatever? Well, this model had a toggle where you could take its pants off, and it had not only... an erect penis, but a not erect penis toggle. So it was a little, what do you use that for? But what are you asking me? I don't have a penis toggle. I don't know, for self-gratification. What are you asking me for? You're asking the world. I don't think the world knows. I really don't. And I'm sorry that we have to live in such a confusing world. It's impossible to navigate. Wouldn't a penis slider make more sense? Yeah, but I think that would be more difficult to make. That's the issue. Where are we? Because 2D stuff, live 2D stuff is very time consuming. And to make the penis, like, grow animation... Ugh, I don't even wanna... Let's... Oh my god, it's the bowling balls! Bowling pins. How'd I meet... I didn't meet him! I didn't meet him! It was some random VTuber I saw on Twitter! Somebody showed me, they were like, look at this! And I was like, I don't want to look at that! Stream it not 4 a.m. Well, when? No, it didn't have a whole animation of it. It didn't. It just had the on and the off, if you know what I mean. It was just the big and the not big one. Stop asking! I had that... Hey, did you guys know that 90% of the United States produce is grown in California? Isn't that crazy? And did you know that 90% of all of the world's almonds is grown in California? Now that's nuts. Fuck almonds. Yeah, that's why California is in a drought. It's true. Almonds drink a lot. They're very thirsty. In my throat. I probably shouldn't be talking at it so much. I don't know why I'm here right now. Oppenheimer, but it came out and dropped in 2007.
When I came to you with those calculations, we thought we might start a chain reaction that would
I don't know what we're watching. It's kind of just like background while I talk about things that don't matter. You know? Did I just click on the same video twice?
When I came to you with those calculations.
I didn't watch Oppenheimer because I hate movies.
We thought we might start a chain reaction.
Because
destroy the entire world.
If I have to sit through a 3-hour long movie, I think it would be the worst day of my life. I think it would be the worst. I can sit through a 2-hour long movie, but 3 hours is pushing it. Watching The Batman was like the worst. The Batman. You know, the one that came out like 2 years ago? But 2 hours is perfect. If it's a good movie. But if it's a bad movie, then I don't want to watch it. But Godzilla Minus One was good, and that was like 2 hours. Oh, I saw this already. I really like Hololive movies. I don't know what it is about idols that just like... It makes me want to shit my pants. I was genuinely put on this world to love them. And every single time I listen, there's a song from Idolmaster Cinderella Girls called Otahen Anthem. And it's about, well, it's basically about Rieimu and how she's a fucked up idol, but there's like these chants in the background. And there's this chant where they say, I was put on this world to love you. And I always say, that's literally me. That is literally me. Every single time I think about Miku, I get so excited. I need a new pen light because I rocked out with my cock out too hard and I threw it and now it doesn't work anymore. And now I only have one, and how can I exist with only one pen light? I'm a fucking loser, I'm a faker, I'm a fraud now because I only have one. That sucks. What the fuck did you just say to me? Watch this too, what is it? Why are you farting? Oh, it's Blue Archive. Wait, guys, can you... So... I know at least 45% of you guys are Stone Cold Coomers, so I need some help. There's this girl from Azur Lane, I think? And she's got white hair. And she really likes pudding. Who is she? Because she's literally me for real. And I need to know about her. She's got white hair and... a mustache. Help. Help. Blue Archive. Yeah, who from Blue Archive? Not Azur Lane. Who from Blue Archive, mustache, white hair? Sorry, this one that we're seeing right now with the Blue Archive. Shirina. Thank you. I need to learn about her because I really like her. Because she's just like me for real, for real. Except she's a communist. It's Kikuo! Oh no, it's Maki. Kokusha. Does she know about Blue Archive a lot? I like Kikuo. What's the fucked up twist gonna be? What is it? I feel a premonition that God's gonna make me fall. She's into new sensations. Mookie, see the cat that light. She's got right. A new addiction for every day and night. She let you close so fat, go dancing in the rain. She let you eat her crazy life, but she'll take away your pain. Up the door, inside the door, she's thinking of being on the car. Of course, Maki would make something like this. Of course. It's been a while since I've seen one of his videos. He used to be like a really, really big Toho fan. Yeah, her! I literally wish she was me. I'm changing my whole self. Wow. Don't I have a mustache too? I can be whatever you want me to, sweetheart. Yeah, I can have a mustache. Sorry, I don't know anything about fighting games. This doesn't resonate, but it was very impressive.
Mentos, the fresh maker.
It is a lot. Peter Griffin! This is what Peter Griffin Fortnite should have looked like. What the fuck? What is this?
Girl, you're gonna feel a
little. Oh, it's this! I think about this a lot. I have this in my liked videos. What the fuck? Not the nightcore! Not the fucking American Dad nightcore. What's better, Family Guy or American Dad? American Dad is consistently better. But I feel like when American Dad is bad, it's worse than Family Guy could ever be. You know, like, American Dad has the highest highs and the lowest lows. But I would definitely rather watch that than Family Guy. Family Guy when you're alone in a hotel room at 11 p.m. You know what I was thinking about the other day? I couldn't stop thinking, man, I really wish I had some canned green beans. That sounds so yummy right now. But then all I could hear in my head was, ew, Mari, canned green beans are gross. That's icky. That's gross. And then, like, I shooed those thoughts away and I thought, man, canned green beans would taste so good if I didn't have some bitch-ass motherfuckers in my ears telling me they're bad. Canned green beans are good, and I'm sticking to it. Everything is so much better when you're alone, because nobody can tell you that what you love is wrong. And that's why I am the way that I am, I guess. I learned something about life, unfortunately. And I realized that you can't make friends unless you're a good friend yourself. And that kind of hurt. It kind of hurt. I thought for a long time, I thought, why can't I just have friends? You know? But you know, you can't have friends if you see everybody as a nuisance. That's ridiculous. The boys. If you want friends, you need to want friends. But like, for real, for real. Roger's cilantro dance. Wait, Twirlin Curtis is here. Everybody, tell them how good that Costco hot dogs is. El gato no es bueno. Cilantro es cantante. Cilantro es muy famoso. Cilantro. They've never had a Costco hot dog before. You had one today? Lucky.
Damn, hombre, you can dance.
Eat it. Literally, I'm telling you, if you can buy a fucking hot dog that'll fill you up plus a drink for $1.50, you're literally not, if you don't like it, you're not losing anything. It's $1.50. It's the longest hot dog you'll ever see in your life. Longer than mine. And that's saying something, dude. It's like, it looks like it's over a foot long, bro. It's the biggest hot dog and the thickest bread you'll ever see. And you can slather that shit in whatever you want. Don't let anyone talk in your ear. Okay, you can put whatever condiments you want on it. Okay, you can put mustard. You can put ketchup. You could put onion. You could put relish. Mustard? Yeah. Yeah, mustard. Yeah. They removed the onions. The onions are gone again? Cheepy, cheepy, chop it, chop it, dooby, dooby, dabba, dabba, magical, nee, boo, nee, boo, nee, boom, boom, boom. Please bring back the onion machine. TikTok tunes! The fact that this is a YouTube channel is really funny to me. I don't know why. What is this? The Costco hot dog is 9 inches? Well, to me, it's like over a foot. To be honest, I think that the Costco hot dog is just absolutely abhorrently long. I mean, who could even eat that much hot dog? Ridiculous. This guy is a classic. My favorite. I think I might need to stop streaming. I think I was a little bit crazy. A little tiny bit crazy. But I think by tomorrow I'll be completely better. I crossed my fingers, so that means I'm not jinxing myself. And I'm gonna play... I'm gonna play old school RuneScape. Yeah. I'm gonna play old school RuneScape, so that'll be fun. Cheepy cheepy choppa choppa dooby dooby daba daba. What are we gonna listen to on the way out? Let's listen to... No. Okay. You know what? I was actually thinking about H3 today. I can't give credit. I don't know why. I was like trying to remember something about him. I was like, I kept like, I was in bed and I was like, remember him, there's something you need to remember. Remember this for later, and now I can't remember it. Oh, it's because he had a really banging YouTube outro. That's it. Wait, hold on. YouTube outro. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I don't like H3, but I can't deny as a pretty banging YouTube outro that I'm going to steal and use for my own good right now. Intro. Yeah, intro. So now I'm gonna bring you guys to somewhere else. I need to stop talking. I'm glad I streamed at least a little bit, though. I'm gonna bring you guys to... I know. Raid Mozumi Peachy. I really like Mozu, so... She's drawing right now, so... I'm gonna bring you guys to her. She's cool. And she's pretty. Yeah. Mozu and I. Well, I like her. That's all I'll say. I really like her. I also really like her huge knockers. That's it's a good charm point. I'm not gonna lie. I love a girl with a big fat rack. Anybody should. We need to normalize people loving girls for their boobs. Small or big. Wait. I'm not like trying to objectify women. I'm just saying, like, we should be able to appreciate girls' boobs. We should be able to appreciate girls' small boobs and girls' big boobs and just be able to say it, like, wow, that girl has a nice boobs. Like, damn, that girl's got two inflatable cushions on her chest, or, man, that girl's flat as a board. I like that. Yeah, we should learn to appreciate the small things. And the big things. I'm a pervy old man. Goodbye.